Poštovane kolege I koleginice,
dear ladies and gentlemen,
ovaj rad se može samo nastaviti na
this paper can be seen as continuation of the previous paper by Professor Beuković.
Upravo preskočim onaj deo koji se odnosi na stanje zeca.
I would like to skip the first part of, on the importance of management of hare. The aim of this work was to analyze of the status of the hare population in central Serbia to see the density and the harvesting mass, to see the percentage of alive litter, the age of the litter, and the inhabitants of here in central Serbia.
For this analysis, the data from the hunting grounds of central Serbia were used, which were gathered during the year 2011-2012. These data are from 36 hunting grounds and are concerned with the spring abundance, with the parent flock of hares. With the harvest of leverets, the percentage, proportion of certain age groups in the population. During the year 2012, from these hunting grounds, samples of eye lenses of the hares were gathered and the age groups were determined in order to study the dependence of the influence of forests on the hunting grounds.
The hunting grounds were grouped into the 8 hunting areas, the importance of which is equal, but they were divided according to the area. They were grouped up to 10%, up to 20%, and over 25% of the intake of forests in 13 of the harvesting grounds.
The data concerning the spring abundance of hares were taken from the annual management plans for hunting grounds, which the manager of the hunting grounds is obliged to submit. The number of settled hares was taken from the organizations which implemented the settling of hares. Concerning the determination of the age of hares, it was carried out by the method of the dry weight of eye lenses. You have heard from Professor Beuković about this method. So from the first hunt, we collect the eye lenses.
Unfortunately,
in central Serbia, there is no tradition of doing a trial hunt with the first hunting day of the season. So sampling was even in November, which is the first hunting day. The eye lenses were submitted, they were cleaned, and fixation was done in 10% formalin. The eye lenses were dried at 37 degrees Celsius for 72 hours in a laboratory in Zemun with a scale and with an accuracy of plus minus 1 milligram. We analyzed 1,534 ocular lenses from 33 hunting grounds in central Serbia. So in central Serbia, the Management Association works in 36 hunting grounds. which expand on almost 33,000 hectares each. Unlike Vojvodina, where this method has been used for 40 years and every hunting ground submits the samples, this is not exactly the case. Based on the weight of eyelenses, the hares were grouped into different age classes, up to 3 months old, is less than 100 milligrams, and then from 3 to 6 months, between 100 and 200 milligrams, the weight of the dry eyelands, then from 200 to 180 milligrams up to 1 or 2 years, and from 370 milligrams 2 to 3 years, and over 370 years older than 3 years. The percentage of young hares was determined within the following limits, so less than 50% it was poor, 51% is good, 56 to 64% is very good, and over 65% is an excellent percentage of leverets. The data was processed using the GLM procedure. As for the results, you can see that on the total area of 862,000 hectares, there was almost 81,000 individuals. So this is the total area of the hunting ground, but the actual active part of the hunting ground is significantly less. The breeding stock in the given hunting grounds is 67,730 individuals, which is 7.85% per hectare, individual per hectare. So the harvest amount per 100 hectares was 1.2. So if you compare the Podunavlje area and the Šumadija area, you see that the difference in harvest is not significant, it's almost the same, which shows that there is a problem concerning the management of the hunting grounds. As for the age structure of the population, the 36 hunting grounds, based on the analysis of the dry weight of the eyelenses, it was determined that the proportion of hares was 57%, almost 58%, which is a good result. The greatest variability was in the category up to 3 months and in the category between 1 and 2 years of age. And this will be explained later. Whether the influence of the forest and the hunting ground area has an influence on the age group of the hares, the effect of the hunting ground area is not significant in most age groups, except in the age group of 1 to 2 years, this can be explained by the fact that in 2011 there was a high
padavina, tako da
there was abundant rain, and it influenced the growth and the abundance of hares in the next year. The coefficient of determination, which explains the variability of the effect of the hunting area and the forest, you can see that these two factors
može se objasniti mali udeo variabilnosti u starosnoj
small variability in the age structure can be explained except for the age group 1 to 2 years where the coefficient of determination was 0.48
govori da tu možda ima
which means that perhaps these two factors had a higher influence on the structure of on the age structure of the population, especially in the age groups 1 to 2 years. This can be explained based on the research of Hochländer from 2012, the negative factors such as predation and rainy springs are more expressed if the hare's habitat has a poor structure and plant diversity. So if the optimal habitat, the negative factors are less influential.
Ako posmatramo
if we observe the share of leverets in these hunting areas, the least percentage was in the area of Šumadija with 55%, while the Podinsko-Kolubarsko area had a high percentage of 59.30%. As for the growth evaluation, we can conclude that the Podinsko-Kolubarsko area has excellent growth results, while the Šumadija area has weak result. As for the settling of hares in hunting grounds in central Serbia, during 2011 it was very weak. There was a lot of perspiration, heavy rain, a small percentage of hunting associations which decided to sell hares. Only 7% were settled. Which compared to the optimal stock for the hunting ground, it is between 1.1 and 15.56 individuals. Catching hares during 2011 compared to the total hare abundance was merely 0.26%, or 1.94% of the total use of the population. Unlike that result in 2008,
ukupno korištenje populacije
the total use of the abundance
4.6%
was tourism, hunting tourism and capturing hares, while the rest was use of domestic hunters. The use of the population was for settling.
Dosta, da kažemo, malo.
This is a very small percentage, and I believe that a lot of factors have an influence on that.
Slaba ekonomska moć pojedinih korisnika lovišta,
ability of some of the hunting grounds, then the administrative problems concerning the licensing for settling of hares. If you do not have the settling predicted in your management plan, then you have to correct the management plan, which is a long administrative process which takes a lot of time, and a lot of hunting grounds which even had the abilities did not implement them at the end. So to conclude, the optimal hare stock In the study, the hunting grounds was between an average of 9.48 individuals per 100 hectares. The breeding stock is between 8.16 and 12.01 per 100 hectares. And it is important to stress concerning the recommendations that 28 hunting grounds could hunt according to plan, 16 hunting grounds, 44% of hunting grounds had to do a correction of the management plan, 22% of the hunting plan had hunting grounds had to do suspension of hunting, and only 16.67 there was hunting according to plan, which is and for six hunting grounds, the samples were small and no recommendations could be given. If 66.6 hunting grounds used the hare population according to the management plan, then this would result in the reduction of the breeding stock for the given hunting grounds. And that the statistical significant difference decrease was only in the age groups of 1 to 2 years. The influence of forested areas is not significant for other age groups, and for the proportion of leverets in the hare population. The settling of hares is very small, only 790 individuals, which is a small percentage compared to the optimal abundance of the hare population. As for the status which caused this, the economical situation in hunting grounds, as well as the administrative problems. Based on these results, we conclude that in order to preserve the abundance of the hare population, the hunters need to do the correct determination of the age structure and the abundance, and that each year we need to determine the age structure based on the weight of dry islands in order to get recommendations concerning the management plans. And we can see that in areas, hunting grounds where the management plans and everything else was done according to plan and correctly, the population was preserved. Thank you very much.